Are you?
I'm Jason.
Nice to meet you. Nice to know you too. You and Bob.
Yo.
And so at that point, my life went downhill very fast, from 13 to being in the top of my year in school.
You have a debate, or you last?
I've had a debate, yeah. It'll be on soccer sports.
Okay.
Yeah.
2 years. That's what happens when you reject God. You can go downhill very, very fast.
I agree.
And within 2 years, I was actually... I'd left home, I'd been thrown out of school at 14, I'd been thrown out of college, I'd had a fight with my father, and I'd been thrown out of my home. And I'd ended up living in a squat, right? Taking drugs, begging on the streets, and living like a very degenerate lifestyle. My parents, who didn't go to church, didn't practice any religion, were at wits end. 15-year-old and out in the world off the rails. They don't even know where I am. They don't even know if I'm dead or alive. And so they said there's only one thing that we can do for our suffering.
Yeah.
I'm probably crying. I'm normally crying. They said we would pray. Two people that never went to church, never practiced their religion, never did anything, got down by the side of their bed, knelt down and asked God to save their son.
And you're still here today?
200 miles away, well, something else. While they were praying, 200 miles away, God began to work in my life. A young man turned up and he started to speak to me from this little book, right? And he started talking to me from this book. And I said, I don't know whether what you say is true. So I just thought about it. I went back to the place I was living, and it's a house that was broken into. They called it a squat.
Yeah.
Broken into this house,
yeah,
and I was living in this squat. And God started to speak with me. Not in a voice, but he started to convict me of my sin. He started to show me my life was wrong. He started to show me that I was actually like, I'd gone off the rails, that I was living a bad lifestyle. This lifestyle was destructive. Up until then, I didn't care. I suddenly became aware of my predicament and the predicament I was in. And I started to wake up. Anyway, cut a long, shortish thought. I went. The first thing I thought to do was I felt unclean.
Yeah.
I felt unclean.
Yeah.
And the only thing I knew to do, it sounds stupid, the only thing I knew to do was have a wash. Because I felt physically unclean, but I also was spiritually unclean. I had a bath. I hadn't had a bath for months, probably. A long time I hadn't had a bath. So the first thing I did was to try to sort out the outward person. You know, sometimes that's what we do when we start trying to sort out the outside. But God's interested in sorting out the inside of us. And then that night, I decided to do what we used to do was we used to go down to the local pub and drink Stumpy. So I went down to this pub.
I remember Stumpy.
To drink some Stumpy because it was cheapest chips. Cheapest chips. You could buy a pint of that for 10p or something. It's ridiculously cheap and stuff. And it's very effective. So I went down to this pub to drink this. And the guy who's preached to me the day before, he walked into the pub, but he didn't come in the pub. He stood in the doorway. He just stood in the doorway and just looked at me. And the longer he looked at me, the more I knew. Don't ask me how I understood, but I knew that he was asking me a question. What was I going to do? What was I going to do with the information he'd given me? Was I going to stay in the position I was in? Or was I going to come out? And I decided that night to leave that place and to go with this person. And I left, I walked out of that town at 11 o'clock at night. I had no money, no possessions or anything. And we travelled around the country and I ended up in a living in a Christian commune in a place called Bath. Did you know the amazing thing about the story? Not only were my parents praying at that time and listening to what happened to me, that guy had only been a Christian for 2 weeks. 2 weeks. He'd only discovered Christ 2 weeks earlier. And he was going around telling people and changing people's lives. And when I got home eventually I realised that I had to go back and see my parents, because I've been away from home and living well. They were at their wit's end. I contacted them by phone and I said, I'm coming home. And my mother said, I knew that you would come back changed. I said, you knew. That's the power of prayer, that's the power of God to change people's lives.
Yeah, we believe in that, we believe.
That's what changed your life.
No, no, no.
That's my story. But it wasn't through study, it wasn't through long research, it was just God intervening in my life.
Me personally, I've always believed in the Creator since we were a kid. So